question of veganism. Like, so I want to ask comparatively, like Carl Cohen's Western philosopher's argument that animals don't have lives. So what he says is that right is a claim that one party may exercise against other, and it can only exist when you can basically make a moral claim against something else. So where does the right to life of animals?
I missed that word.
Yeah. So
animals don't have.
So rights exist only among beings,
okay,
who can basically make a moral claim against one another. So maybe if we go with an example, right now we have so there is coronavirus. It originated from the bats initially. So if you are going to a scenario where you have to protect the life of animals, and you indeed need to kill a bat and create a vaccine, so where will the extent of right to life go in the protection of humans or so? So that
see,
is the question.
If a human being threatens your life, in that case you have the right to kill even a human being, no? So why conjure a hypothetical situation where you say that if the coronavirus, the COVID, is threatening the life of a human being, should we kill the virus or not? Or if a bat is the carrier of the virus, should we kill the bat or not? In extreme situations, you can kill even human beings. But we are not talking of extreme situations here. We are talking of general day-to-day life. Would you go after the virus if it is not threatening you? Please. Would you go after the virus if it is not threatening you? If it threatens you, by all means, go after it. In that case, if even a human being threatens you, you have all the rights to even kill that human being in self-protection. But why kill an animal? Is the animal really threatening you?
So that wasn't exactly the question. Imagine if there is an animal which is basically causing the virus here, maybe in India or somewhere. Okay. So we found that a similar kind of animal exists maybe somewhere which is not threatening us, but which may have the potential, if we research it, potential cause for the cure. So will we go to that animal and actually protect our own species now, which is not threatening to us?
That obviously has to be the last resort. You see, again, you are talking of an extreme situation. But before you do that, you must be honestly convinced that you have exhausted all other options. Have you? We have intellect and we exercise our intellect so aggressively for so many purposes. Even in this regard, let's first exercise our intellect equally aggressively. So let's first of all exhaust all other options, and then if it turns out that if you don't kill that particular animal, the entire human race can be jeopardized, then you go ahead and kill the animal, fine. But then that is a 0.00001% chance. That is an utter extreme. When we are talking of not exploiting animals, when we are talking of vegetarianism or veganism, then we are not talking of extreme situations. An extreme situation invokes apadharma, right? We are talking of our day-to-day life. In your day-to-day life, do you really require to have that egg on your plate as the breakfast, for your breakfast? That's what we are discussing here. Not an extreme situation. In an extreme situation, seriously, if I am the carrier of the virus, by all means execute me. Why should one man's life be so important that the entire human race and knowledge and civilization is threatened because of it? I mean, execute me, fine, I'll be okay with it.